Former President Donald Trump, apparently a big fan of Cenk Uygur, watches the show and even posts about some of Cenk's arguments on Truth Social. I'm not kidding. So apparently Trump, as we have shared with you on this show, had some difficulty in regard to his massive legal liability in regard to the financial fraud case that he lost, right? So as a result of losing that case, he was ordered to pay $464 million. And that bond amount was undoable. So he appealed it. And recently, the judgment against him was lowered significantly to $175 million. Now, if he fails to pay that, it could lead to some of his prized real estate basically getting seized by the state of New York, where they took him to trial for the financial fraud. And before the bond was reduced, Cenk and I discussed it on the show, and here's what Cenk had to say about it.
But in terms of what's right and fair, we can't have one set of rules for Trump and another set of rules for everyone else. And to me, putting up all the cash up front before you appeal the case seems draconian for everyone, not just Trump, right? And it's white collar crime. Look, I want it punished maximum. And if he loses the appeal, damn right, sell all your properties and pay up, okay? But what if he wins the appeal? So you made him sell all of his properties to get the collateral, but then he can't buy them back. And if he had to sell them in a fire sale, so when his lawyer says irreparable harm, in this case, financially speaking, it would be irreparable harm.
Trump loved that argument, absolutely loved it. And he posted about it on I say that he posted about it on Truth Social, but I don't know. So it is his Truth Social account, here's the post, and you tell me if it sounds like something Trump himself would post. Progressive commentator Cenk Uygur, also firmly anti-Trump, had a similar view. To me, putting up all the cash up front before you appeal the case seems draconian for everyone, not just Trump, Uygur said on his program, The Young Turks. But what if he wins the appeal? So you made him sell all of his properties to get the collateral, but then he can't buy them back. So when his lawyer says irreparable harm, in this case, financially speaking, it would be irreparable harm.
Yeah. So there's a couple of issues here. Number one is yes, but what did he leave out? Two, are we the fairest show in America? Yes.
Three, asked and answered.
Three, was that Donald Trump himself writing it? These are all fun questions. And did I mean what I said there? So I'll answer them one by one. Is it him writing it? This one's academic because he posted it, right? He posted it along with, I think, 43 posts that night, Easter night. And
how dare he do that on Easter Sunday? That's blasphemous.
Yeah, that's what they would say about Biden and all that stuff. It's hilarious. In reality, he didn't mention Easter at all. He just cried and whined about all of his cases and then tweeted an article where he compared himself to Jesus Christ. Okay, so that's Donald Trump for you guys. So that's the actual Donald Trump. These must have been prepared ahead of time for him, and he's posting ones that like his team is giving him. Because there's no way that Donald Trump says of me, progressive commentator Cenk Uygur. That's not the kind of language he uses. He'd be like, progressive bozo, Cenk Uygur.
I know.
Even he. And then he's
actually really disappointed because I would have wanted to hear his read his posts in his own word.
I know. Radical left bozo.
Totally.
Chunky yogurt. Okay. And here it says also firmly anti-Trump had a similar view, right? He would have said, normally a Trump hater waiter. Had a view that was along Trump lines because Trump is right.
Totally, it would have been way more fun.
It would have been more fun. This is definitely prepared by his staff, but he did read it and post it and thinks it makes his case.
No random capitalizations.
Oh yeah, this is
really disappointing actually.
Yeah. I mean, he's tweeted about me before. He's tweeted about our 2016 election night. That video a couple of times, right? So we're all familiar. Hey, MAGA, if you don't know, yes, we're familiar with it, okay?
But you know, so, luckily for MAGA, they've never had any election related meltdowns, ever.
No, never. No. Like, that was what was so hilarious. In 2016, we were bummed and then angry at the Democrats for blowing the election to Trump, right? Yeah. And that's mainly what we talked about. And they're like, and we were the ones saying that Trump could win all along. So then they make this video of like, Young Turks meltdown in 2016. And then 2020, they lose and they had the most epic meltdown literally in American history. They rushed the Capitol. They're like, yeah, we didn't lose. We couldn't lose, frothing at the mouth and stuff. So what happened now, epic meltdown bros?
Yeah.
Anyways, look, back to Trump.
I have to say though,
yeah,
I do cringe at my reaction in 2016.
Yeah,
I have to take some responsibility for it. Like, I don't feel good about it. Go ahead.
I feel great about it. I was amazed, like, first of all, yes, I am a firmly anti-Trump critic. That's right. And so one part of that is definitely correct. And yeah, I was bummed and angry that Trump won. I was mainly angry at Hillary Clinton and the dumbass Democratic establishment and the dumbass mainstream media.
No, I get it.
We're like, hey, we have it locked up. You don't even have to come out and vote. We're so good.
I agree with you on that. I'm specifically talking about myself because I took it out on the voters. And I just wish I hadn't done that. That's all.
All right, yeah. you're too fair, as we are here. So did I mean the things that that he's quoting me as? Absolutely, yes. Is it in context? Good enough context, yes. So he's not misquoting me. I do believe that, and you saw it in the video that we just played you. You know why I say things that are seem to be pro-Trump in that case? Because I'm honest.
And you're not a propagandist.
Yeah, and I don't do propaganda. I do the news. So if someone takes all of your property and you sell it in a fire sale to put up a bond, you don't get to buy it back at the same price. You just don't. That's not how the markets work. It's gone. You have to try to rebuy it and probably at a significant premium. So that is a massive, massive financial hit on someone that has not gone through the entire appeals process. But did they leave out portions of what I said? Of course. I also said, I think he did do this fraud. I think he is guilty. But I'm fair, I want the appeals process to play out. Mm-hmm. And if he loses, as I suspect, throughout the entire appeals process, then you should take everything he has, because that's how the law works. And he's not above the law, but he's also not below the law. And that's what makes us unique here.
Yeah.
Where the right-wing media will tell you he's above the law and he shouldn't be prosecuted for any crimes that he clearly committed. And left-wing or mainstream media will tell you he's guilty of everything and we should take all his crap right now, even before we've proved it all the way through. Right? So whereas we try to deliver the truth for you guys, whether it's going to be good or bad, Trump will likely tweet about us more or post about us, etc. It is what it is, and we don't mind. And by the way, our enemies will probably use this against us. Did you know that Trump once quoted you saying something that's true? How dare you? Yeah, I dare. I dare say things that are true, even if it's positive to Trump. For half a second. Thanks for watching The Young Turks, really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat, emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun. But you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.